The last thing I'd like to show you is teleporting Ellen from one place to another. There are a few ways to be able to achieve this with the kit, and you can find out most of those ways through the component reference guide that we have on the website, as well as in the documentation folder in the project. So I'm going to exit play mode, and still in the interactables folder, I've got this teleporter, which I'm going to put right here. And if we look at the teleporter in the inspector, there's a transition point component here. And right now the transition type is to a different zone. And I don't want to do that. I want to just teleport her maybe back to the beginning of this level. So I'm going to click on different zone and select same scene, because it's within this same scene that we'll be teleporting. And right now it doesn't know what to teleport. So I need to select Ellen and click and drag her into the transitioning game object section here. Another thing that it's expecting is a destination. So this looking for the destination transform, right now it doesn't have a position to do that. I can just quickly set that up by dragging in another teleporter from the prefabs folder. Like so. And that's because it's got the same name, it's added a 1 to it. So let's remember that teleporter 1 is at the beginning of the level and the original teleporter is up here. So we don't need to touch this transitioning point at all. We can just leave it as it is. And if we go back to the original teleporter, let's click and drag this teleporter 1 from the hierarchy into the destination transform. So it's taking the position of where this game object is placed, and it will transport Ellen from the originating position to the destination. So we need to change when it transitions. So the transition when option, if we click on that, we've got a few options, and we can do it when on trigger enter. So when we actually walk past it, it'll be able to teleport Ellen. So I'm going to collect the key, I'm going to cheat and jump over the door, and it jumps me straight into the spikes. That's horrible gameplay. So there's the teleportation, that works, but I don't want it that immediate. I want to be able to give the player the chance to interact and then teleport. So I'm going to exit play mode. I'm also going to remove those spikes so I don't end up killing myself every time. And selecting the original teleporter again, which is the one up here. If I change the transition when to interact press, the interact button in this project is set to E. So when I press E, when I'm at the teleporter, I should teleport. So it gives you a bit of a chance to teleport. So if I'm just walking past it, it won't move me back to the beginning again. But if I do press the E key, now it's teleported me. Lastly, let's enable some dialogue to come up on the screen to tell our player what button to press to enable the teleporter. So in our prefabs folder, I'm going to go to UI prefabs, and we have a dialogue canvas here. I'm going to click and drag this into the UI section here. This is just for some organizational purposes, so I know what the UI is. And if I click in this empty space, it's actually grayed out, and that means that it's not enabled. So when we press play, it won't come up automatically with a big dialog box. We need to trigger this to enable when an event happens. So let's create that event now. If I click on the original teleporter, which is the one that I want to walk past to trigger the canvas, it doesn't currently have an event system in at the moment, so I'm going to add component, and I'm going to type in interact, and that's going to come up with all the interact options here. So I want the interact on button 2D, and when selecting these for specific collision interactions, which is what we're using now, selecting the 2D option is important because we are in a 2D game. So I've clicked and added that in, and now I'm going to make sure that only Ellen can walk past this and trigger the event. So on the layers, I'm going to select nothing to clear the selections, and then I'm going to select player. So on enter, we want something to happen. We want to trigger the dialogue canvas to say something. So I'm going to add something to the list, find the dialog canvas in the hierarchy, click and drag that in the empty space, and then on the function, I'm going to look at the specific dialog canvas controller function here. And what I want to do is activate canvas with text, and then it's got a little string there. If I type something in here, unlike the animated door, it's actually going to display text in the dialog box. So if I trigger this now, and I walk past it, if I collect the key and jump over it and cheat, it brings up a blank text box. So we want to type something in that function to display. So we want to say press E to teleport. So now when I press play again, now that I've entered in some text there, and collect the key and slowly sink down on the door, now it says press E to teleport. So I can still press E to teleport. So now you can see that it's still appearing on the screen, and we don't, that's going to stay on there permanently because we haven't set anything to on exit. So when Ellen walks outside of the collision zone, we haven't set it to remove itself. So that's what we're going to do now. So if we look at the interact on button 2D, we have an on exit where we can put some events to trigger when we leave this green collider box. So I'm going to add one to the list, drag in the dialog canvas from the hierarchy, and select the function from the dialog canvas controller. We've got a deactivate canvas with delay, and here it's expecting a float instead of a string, so it's expecting a number. So we're going to put in a number of 2. I think 2 seconds is about right for this. So now when we exit that green box, it'll wait a little bit before the canvas disappears. And that's it for this session. I hope you enjoyed creating some gameplay with no code with the 2D game kit. You can download this asset off the asset store, and you can also learn more. We have all the getting started guide and documentation on the Learn site. We also have it inside the project as well, so if you need it offline, that's where you can find it. And we also have a forum thread, so if you get stuck or need some ideas, you can go there too. Check out the game that's included with the pack, and you can see how a lot more different gameplay elements are all hooked up together. I hope this was helpful, and we'll see you later.